Hello everyone, this is Revan from Digi Integrative. Welcome to Tech News episode 268. The Income Tax Department of India on Wednesday raided the premises of brands like Xiaomi, Oppo, Foxconn India, Bharat FIH and Dixon Technologies in South India. The raid comes after intelligence input suggested secrecy in income and evasion of taxes by the companies. Around 20 premises in the National Capital Region, Mumbai, Rajkot and Karnataka linked to Oppo and Xiaomi were searched. One of the biggest commuters face while booking a cab in India is a constant question asked by the driver, which decides the fate of your drive. The question is, what's your drop location? If your answer matches the cabbie's preferred destination, then the drive is on, or else better luck finding another cab. Next in line is another most important question asked by drivers on cab hiring platforms: what's your method of payment for this ride? Many drivers cancel or deny the ride based on the way of commuter is paying for the service, as most cab drivers prefer getting paid straight up with the cash after the ride ends. And to bring respite from this constant rejection faced by commuters and interrogating questions, cab service platform Ola has taken a strong step to solve this issue. In its new update, Ola drivers will be able to see your drop and destination and also the mode of payment before accepting the ride. This fresh update comes as a step to have fewer cancellation and quicker ride access. And the second most popular question is, why does my driver cancel my Ola ride? Ola is trying to fix this industry-wide issue. Ola drivers will now see approx drop location and payment mode before accepting a ride. Enabling drivers is a key to reducing cancellation. India banned over 20 YouTube channels and 2 websites on Monday for running anti-India propaganda from Pakistan. Invoking for the first time the emergency powers under the newly notified Intermediary Guidelines and Digital Media Ethics Code in the IT Act, the propaganda was being run with the aid of Pakistan's inter-service intelligence, according to officials. They said one of the group identified was Naya Pakistan, which has over 2 million subscribers on YouTube, was running false news on issues such as Kashmir farmers' protest against the farm laws in Ayodhya. Among the YouTube channels banned by India, 15 are owned by Naya Pakistan Group, while the other include the Naked Truth, 48 News and the Junaid Halim Official. Honor Magic 5 foldable has been officially teased by the company. The teaser image doesn't clarify whether it will have a book-like hinge or a clamshell fold design. The Honor Magic 5 is speculated to arrive with the Qualcomm Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 chipset. Vivo will soon launch the Vivo V23 series in India. The brand showcased the Vivo V23 and Vivo V23 Pro during the ongoing Pro Kabaddi League in the country. The promo video played during the commercial slot showcases the device in all their glory. A Japanese professor has developed a prototype lickable TV screen that can imitate food flavors, another step towards creating a multi-sensory viewing experience. This device, called as the Taste the TV, uses a carousel of 10 flavor canisters that spread in combination to create the taste of a particular food. The flavor sample then rolls off hygienic film over a flat TV screen for the viewer to try. In the COVID-19 era, this kind of technology can enhance the way people connect and interact with the outside world, which was said by this professor. And the goal is to make it possible for people to have the experience of something like eating at a restaurant on the other side of the world, even while staying at home. According to the leaks, the iQ 9 Pro will be coming up with more than 6-inch WQHD plus 120Hz E5 LTPO AMOLED display, and it also having a Qualcomm Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 processor. And if we talk about the camera, it will come with a 50MP main camera, 50MP of ultra wide angle lens, and a 16 or 32MP of front facing camera. If we talk about the battery, it may come with the 4700mAh battery with 100W fast charging support. Android 12 update rollout would begin for eligible Motorola smartphones from Feb 2022. 30 smartphones from the company will receive the Android 12 update, including business edition smartphones. The eligible handsets will be updated to Android 12 with the company's own MyUX skin running on the top. The Xiaomi 12 is a compact powerhouse that aims to offer the best that's possible within the smaller form factor, but it actually tries to deliver the very best that one expects from the flagship level device. It comes with the specifications like a 2K AMOLED screen with a 120Hz intelligent dynamic refresh rate. Samsung's own flagship chipset, tentatively named as Exynos 2200. It is expected to arrive before Feb 2022 when the Galaxy S22 series is rumored to launch. The chipset usually arrives a month or so before the flagship phone arrives, and the company recently confirmed that it will indeed launch early next year. Samsung said that it is preparing a small gift for fans who love gaming. And while some of the speculations are the Exynos 2200 could be a gaming oriented, we should not exclude the option to have the version with the boosted GPU. According to the rumors and leaks, the Galaxy S22 Ultra got the design right, and the poster shows that the upcoming flagship next to another member of the S22 series, like the S22 Plus. The Samsung Galaxy S22 and the S22 Plus will adopt a camera bump similar to the ES Galaxy S21 lineup. Additionally, the poster confirms the S Pen support on the Ultra, while we cannot see the holder from it from this angle. The Chinese tech company Lenovo has been teasing multiple devices like laptop and tablets. Expected to arrive early next year, one of these devices is Lenovo's next generation Legion Y9000P gaming laptop, which the Lenovo has been unveiled. Lenovo has officially teased the Lenovo Y9000P laptop, which is expected to officially be launched in CES 2022. Vivo recently unveiled its new T-Series smartphones in China. The Vivo T-Series of smartphones is soon coming to India as well. It will replace the Vivo Y-Series of smartphones in India by next year. The quest for cutting-edge communication with high-octane network speeds is an area of research that continues to expand. The research and development units of major smartphone manufacturers continue to feel a certain El Dorado. Hawaii and few other companies have shown up snippets of what could be achieved with 6G technology and the great opportunity waiting to be tapped. The Korean tech giant LG has now added to the narrative by proposing to demonstrate the 6G technology during its participation in the 2021 Korean Science and Technology Exhibition from 22 to 24 December 2021. LG will showcase its strides in 6G wireless transmission and reception during the exhibition held at Kintech's Lizen. LG will unveil a power amplifier for 6G for the first time in conjunction with the Fraunhofer Research Institute, Germany. And LG has already tested the 6G power amplifier in Berlin back in August 2021. LG was able to successfully transmit and receive wireless data within a 100-meter direct distance outdoors using a 6G frequency band. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe, and follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.